Evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my channel. So now I'm going to feature the premium variant of the 2020 Proton X50. So if you haven't watched my Proton X50 flagship video, you can check it out that first, which I will tell you more detail about the specification about the Proton X50. So now I'm just gonna focus on the premium spec of the X50. So now let's jump to the engine bay first. So as for the X50 premium spec, you get the same 1.5 liter turbocharged port injection engine, which is same as you found in the 1.5 liter turbo standard and also the executive. So the port injection of the 1.5 liter turbo in this X50 generates 150 horsepower and 226 newton meters of torque. So the power output is slightly less compared to the X50 flagship right there, which uses the TGDI direct injection engine. So this engine is paired with a 7-speed dual clutch transmission. So now let's begin our exterior walk around. So for the exterior, the X50 premium does not differ much compared to the X50 flagship variant right there. Just that you loses up the L2 automatic driving system as you found in the full spec X50 flagship. Otherwise, the exterior, the front fascia is basically identical to the X50 flagship. You still get this red rindings right here, which is standard across all of its variants. And Proton have redesigned the front grills, so it's not the same grill design as you found in the Geely Binyue in China or the Geely Kurei, which is sold in Philippines and Russia. But you still get a 360-degree camera. And the front parking sensors is only standard from the executive variant onwards. And for the premium, it gets LED fog light, which the X50 standard variant does not come with it. And with this black housing right there, makes the car look more sporty. And as for the bumper, as you can see, you get the front lid kind of design, which is finished in this carbon fiber texture. And this part is gloss black. Overall, the front is pretty sporty and also pretty modern. This is how the B-segment SUV is gonna look like. And you get the same color as you found in the Proton Iris. So the tire, you get a set of 18-inch tires, same with the X50 flagship right there. Whereas in the executive and the standard, you get 17-inch single-tone variant. So this 18-inch is finished in dual-tone, and you get red fender calipers for the premium and the flagship variant. So the tire is wrapped in the Continental Ultra Contacts UC6, which is wrapped in 215/55 R18 tires. So you get a 360 side camera right here. And as for the keyless entry, you are getting standard across all of its variant for the both front doors. As you can see, you get the indentation right here. And you get this signature window line, which you also found in the Proton X70. And you get a silver roof rack, but it does not come with the sunroof, only the 1.5 liter flagship variant comes with it. So I forgot to mention that the rear tire, the rear is finished in this brake instead of drum, so good job. And also painted with red calipers. So as for the rear, this is my favorite part of the X50. So apart from the LED tail lights, which is standard across the range, I also like this Proton wording, which is finished in this grey finishing, which gives you a more sporty look. And this silver trim also same with the front grille design, and it extends till the end of the tail lights. And you get the rear spoiler, pretty aggressive rear spoiler, and the third brake light is located right here. So down here, surprisingly, you get quad exhaust pipe for a 3-cylinder 1.5 liter turbo, but it aren't a bad thing because it looks pretty nice and it is also functional. It's not fake, as you found in most German modern vehicles such as the Audi and Mercedes. So at least Proton make the quad exhaust pipe functional. And you get a rear fog light right there together with this diffuser layout right here. So let's check out the interior, shall we? So like I mentioned earlier, you get keyless entry, standard across all of its variant. So after opening the doors, so let's start from the doors. So up here you get soft touch plastic and this door handle design, which is carried over from the Proton X70. And this silver panel right here extends till the whole dashboard. So right here is hard plastic. This is wrapped in red leather. This is leather armrest together with yellow stitch, together with red stitching. So let's get inside the car. Sorry for the noises now because I'm wearing a glove. So the door closings are quite solid, even though it's rather light, but totally fine for a B-segment crossover because the Honda HR-V feels much more lighter than this one. So here's the interior of the Proton X50. So right here you get this similar design detail as you found in the Proton X70. This Chinese motif design double as this manual headlight levering, and this is to adjust the meter brightness, and here is to turn off your traction control. So right here you get a speaker. So here's the steering wheel. So standard for all of its variant, the X50 comes with a flat bottom steering wheel, but for the standard variant it does not get leather wrap finishing. You get a plain steering wheel, but you do get this controls button right here. So this is cycle between your LCD meter cluster right here. So the car is not started, so I cannot show you the meter. Up here is wrapped in soft touch leather with some stitching. And the steering wheel of the X50 is tilt and telescopic. It's tilt and telescopic. So you can find your most ergonomic seating position. And one more thing, you get the footrest right here, and you get a push start right here. So the overall interior quality of the X50 is definitely better than the Honda HR-V full black interior, and lots of plastic going on for the dashboard. So right here gets the silver paneling, nice texture. And as for the premium and the flagship variant, you get the 10.25 inch GKUI 19 high proton system. So right here is you get some buttons right here to tune up your volume or tune down your volume, and also turn on and off the GKUI system. So this button quality are pretty nice. The tactile feel are also quite nice as well. So down here you get the aircon vent. As you can see, the details and the design are overly done, I think so, because as you can see, the hazard light switch is finished in this polygon shape, and the signal stop is on the left side like most Proton car does. And the signal stop quality is much better than the Honda HR-V, and it does get automatic mode. So down here you get the single zone automatic climate control. So for the executive and the standard, you get manual adjustable aircon. So right here to adjust your different modes, and the tactile feelings are also pretty high quality for a 90,000+ vehicle. And this is to control your fan speed with automatic mode, and this is to control your temperature. And this is to tune the aircon to max. And get this signature handle as you find in the X70 as well, but for the X50 you only have in the passenger side. And right here is rubberized, so if you put your phones or coin it won't wobble around, as well as this slot right here. You can put your coins here without making any noise. So this is the same gear knob design as you found in the Proton X70 CKD version. And it's a 7-speed dual clutch transmission. You get manual mode. Overall, these shifters are pretty high quality as well, and you get an electronic parking brake. So you get a cut slot right here, and this is to adjust your different driving modes, and this is your hill descent control, and these two are also exclusive to the premium and the flagship model. But additional to the flagship model, you get the auto parking system, which are not present in the X50 premium. So right here you get the two cup holders without the divider, so you can put your phones here. but it's without the cover, but to me it's totally fine. And here you can put your phone, and inside are all rubberized. Good job in details. And this is the armrest, finished in maroon leather. So open, it reveals a rather shallow storage space. Inside, still rubberized, and it does not click lock, as you can see, but you cannot adjust the angle. So as for the upper part of the car, for the premium and the flagship, you get full black interior. As for the executive and the standard, you get the beige upper part of the ceiling. So right here, you get the dimming light, which is also identical to the Proton Saga, but this one is finished in black. And the tactile feel are also pretty high quality as well. So here's the vanity mirror, but it does not come with the light. So yeah, and as for the driver side, you still get a vanity mirror with a sun visor. So overall, it's a pretty high quality cabin, given that the price are so attractive. So here's the glove box. So the glove box dip down slowly in an elegant manner. And you can get some little pockets right there. And this car total have 6 speakers. And I quite like this aircon vent design. And the material being used are also pretty high quality. So let's check out the rear seats. So this one, I believe, is the fuel box. And down here you get some slot to charge your phone, and also a power outlet. So this car only comes with the screen mirroring and Bluetooth function. It does not come with Apple CarPlay, neither Android Auto. So as you open the door, you are greeted by this. This is hard plastic. This is wrapped in red leather, black leather with red stitching, and some storage space down here. So the rear seats, you cannot recline it. So this is the fixed angle of the seat. So you still get this combination of red and black leather. So let's close the door. I get this much in terms of leg room, this much in terms of headroom. So it's actually not bad. And down here you get a slot to slot your phone, and here 2 USB ports, so that you no need to snatch your friend's charging port in front. You have your individual charging port at the rear. So you get rear aircon vents, 2 seat pockets, and right here you get the central armrest together with 2 holes. And this part is rubberized as well. So you get 3 individual headrests and also ISOFIX for the outer 2 seats. And up here, surprisingly, you get a dimming light, and this is miles high quality than those in the Hondas. It's finished in LED, and the buttons feels are also pretty quite high quality as well. And you get a grip handle together with a hook to hook your clothes. So one more look from the rear. Futuristic interior. So this car total have 6 airbags. Only the standard variant comes with 4 airbags. So because this car does not have the battery, so I cannot pop open the boot to show you the boot space. But you can check it out in my Proton X50 flagship video right there. So I will show you the boot space of the Proton X50. So yeah, this is my walk around video of this 2020 Proton X50 Premium. So if you have any comments, you can let me know in the comment section regarding to the Proton X50 Premium. So be sure to subscribe, like, and share my videos. Cheers.